Hi everyone, it's AG Twins. Welcome back to another video. Today I picked up a Molly doll from Facebook Marketplace. So I'm gonna show you what shape she's in and see if we can fix her up a little bit. So she came with her full meat outfit, including her underwear. The only thing she's missing is the little ribbons that go at the end of her braids, but those shouldn't be too hard to replace. She even has her glasses. And then here's the kind of shape that her hair is in right now. It's kind of messy, but I'm hoping it's nothing that a good wash and brush won't fix. So I undressed her, and I'm kind of finding out that she's a pretty old doll. She has a Pleasant Company tag, and it's even a Made in Germany Pleasant Company tag, so I think that makes this a pretty old doll. She is pretty dirty and has a couple little marks on her face, and her limbs seem dirty as well. But the most interesting thing to me right now is that she feels totally different from the modern American Girl dolls. Just the kind of like texture of her limbs. I don't know how to explain it, but it's almost like she's kind of like squishy. Not super squishy, but her limbs just have a little bit of give to them, which is a little strange and not something that I've seen before. But anyway, I use a magic eraser to clean up her limbs. These were actually way dirtier than I thought they were. Look at that. You can see the line from where I cleaned and did not clean. Oh my goodness. So I'm going to speed this up and give her limbs a really good, thorough cleaning. After her limbs were all cleaned, I sprayed her hair with some water and gave it a good brushing, and it's already definitely looking better, but I'm still going to wash it considering how dirty her limbs were. I just want to make sure that her hair is clean. So I just do this in my bathroom sink, and I'm going to use some Dawn dish soap to wash her hair with, and I also do use some conditioner, just the kind that I had in my shower. I'm not sure that I'm convinced that this works, but I figured why not? It can't hurt. I did also decide to give Molly a hot water dunk. I didn't take any footage of that, but basically what I did is I boiled water on the stovetop, and then once it was boiling, I let it sit for 5 minutes, and then took turns dunking Molly's hair into the hot water for about 5 seconds, and then taking it back out for about 10 seconds before dunking it back in again. So here's what it looks like after that. Even when it's still wet, I can tell that it definitely feels softer already. Then while it was still wet, I braided her hair back into her two signature braids. I did my best to make sure that they were even and that these little hairs at the back of her head actually cover her wig cap. I think I did an okay job. Molly's head was a little loose, and she did have a pretty serious head tilt going on, so the next thing I did was to use a bobby pin to untie the knot in her neck strings. And then I just pushed some of the stuffing back in a little bit and retied the neck strings really tight to make sure that her head was secure on her body. Then the last thing left to do was dress Molly back into her meat outfit. I think I mentioned earlier that the tag on the body of the doll herself was tagged Pleasant Company, and it also said it was made in Germany. So I kind of investigated a little bit more into the tags of these clothing items, And the only item that had an American Girl or Pleasant Company tag on it was her bloomers, which were tagged Pleasant Company, but made in China, not Germany. And all of the other pieces of her meet outfit actually didn't have tags in them. So I'm not sure if they were cut out or if they're just old enough that they didn't come with it to begin with. But that was just an interesting little fun fact that I noticed. Her skirt here is giving me a little bit of trouble. I think it's a little bit small on her since she has kind of a chubbier body than some of the newer dolls, so the Velcro kept coming undone. Her sweater pulls over the head. It doesn't have any Velcro, so I had to cut the video a little bit to get that on her. And then the last thing left is the socks and the shoes. I struggled so much putting these shoes on. I don't tend to have trouble with the black plastic shoes that are similar, that are for my Samantha doll, but I don't know if it's because Molly was wearing socks or if it's just because these are the older version, but this took me a really long time to put them on. I did cut out some of the footage because I figured you didn't need to watch me struggle with your shoes for a full minute. But yeah, these were hard. I definitely get what people are saying about them now. So here's Molly all fixed up and dressed back into her me outfit. I think I have decided, however, that even though I think she is really cute, I think I'm going to be selling this doll. I still want Molly in my collection and I really like her, but I just think that this isn't the doll for me. I just think that the Pleasant Company doll feels so much different than the AG ones I remember from my childhood that she just doesn't feel like an American Girl doll to me. So I think I am going to be selling Miss Molly and then I will still be keeping my eye out for the perfect Molly to join my collection that I connect with a little bit better. Stay tuned for some before and after pictures, but thank you for watching, everybody.